Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In this lecture, I would like to explain another example. That is example 6 based on the strain energy. So find the deflection at the center of the beam of span L carrying a uniform distributed load of W per unit turn over the whole span. Assume uniform flexural rigidity. So already I explained same uniform distributed load model based on the cantilever in the last lecture. But here this is a simply supported beam. Here they are given a uniform distributed load W per unit run of full span length of L. And here we are going to find the deflection at the center of the beam. See here, deflection at the center of the beam. So what I told in the previous lecture, wherever we are going to find the deflection at that point, you have to introduce an imaginary point load. Whenever an UDL is given, and that too we are solving the method in strain energy by using strain energy. See here, I am introducing an imaginary point load at the center point. So take down that one as P. So uniform distributed load will be W per unit run. So I am indicating that one here, W per unit run. Okay. Then this one will be RA, and this one will be RB. See here, our first step is to find the reactions at the support. For example, if a uniform distributed load is acting on a simply supported beam, means the load will be distributed equally. You people know that one. But here, a uniform distributed load, along with that, a point load is acting exactly at the center. Therefore, we are going for the calculation. Then I am taking here the support as A and this one as B. So see here, I am resolving step by step. So I am resolving moment, means taking moment about B, means I am resolving entire moments about this point B. Then I am taking clockwise moments one side, anti-clockwise moments another side. See here, I am resolving the forces about B. So see here, RA into B, this force will be acting clockwise towards B. Therefore, what is the moment here? RA into L, force into distance. This force into distance is the moment which is acting clockwise. So therefore I am taking in the clockwise RA into L. Again anti-clockwise moment. See here, this load, this point load is acting anti-clockwise towards B. And what is the moment here? P into, it is acting exactly at a center. Means full span length will be L and half of the span length will be L by 2. P into L by 2. See here, I am taking P into L by 2 plus, and there will be an uniform distributed load. So full span load only. Take down W into L is the load. And what is the distance? Into half of the distance for the UDL. W into L into L by 2. See here, W into L by 2 will be equal to WL square by 2. And again, this will be acting downwards. And I am resolving the force like this, force into distance which is acting anti-clockwise towards B. Therefore, I am taking in the anti-clockwise section. So this is your equation. Then I am cancelling the L terms here one time. Then you will get RA will be equal to P plus WL by 2. If you simplify this one directly, you will get P plus WL by 2. Again, next step is total vertical load. See here, total vertical load means sum of the vertical loads on the beam. So RA and RB will be acting upwards. Therefore, I am taking RA plus RB equal to this W uniform distributed load. So what is the load here? W into L for the UDL. So which is acting downwards, plus P. P plus W into L, which is acting downwards. Upward forces equal to downward forces. P plus W into L. So already we people know this RA value. So I am taking, if you want RB, if you want RB, I am taking RA value this side. Means I am sending this side, means you will get minus RA. See here, what is RA value? This value, P plus WL by 2. Take down this value here. Then simplify that one, you will get RB value will be equal to P plus WL by 2. So remember one thing, here the loads will be acting in a symmetrical position. Means which is exactly same for both supports A and B. So whatever the movement obtained at A, the same movement will be distributed to the support B also. You please remember that point also. Whenever an uniform distributed load, means a symmetrical loading condition happen, means it will be distributed equally to its supports. Means P plus WL by 2 for A, similarly P plus WL by 2 for B. Then next step, formula. See here, strain energy stored formula. So what is the formula of strain for strain energy? Integral of 0 to L m square dx by 2a. This is the strain energy formula. But here, if you observe one thing, so there will be two sections from here to here and here to here. So I am taking that point as C. C. So from A to C and C to B, there will be two sections which is symmetrical. So already while explaining on a simply supported beam, a point load exits at this concentrated load exits center, means I explain this property. So in the max there will be one property. Integral of 0 to L f of x dx. If the function is even, take down 2 times of 0 to L by 2 f of x dx. Means here there will be two sections. For example, if I solved AC part, you will get the moment. Again, plus CB part, you will get the same moment. So for that reason, what I am doing means, I am taking AC plus CB part equal means 2 times of AC. Okay? Or else, based on the property directly, integral of 0 to L by 2 f of x dx will be equal to 2 times of 0 to L by 2 f of x dx. So you please refer simply supported beam. Point load exactly at the center, there also you will get same property and same condition. See here, 2 times of integral of 0 to L m square dx by 2a, means I am taking 2 times of 0 to L by 2 m square dx by 2a. So for that, our first step is introduce, means consider a section xx. So this section will be xx. Xx at a distance of x from A. Okay. Again, what we are doing means we have to consider section xx in the AC part plus section xx in the CB part. So if you want full length span movement, means what we are doing, strain energy for AC plus strain energy for BC. Then take down 0 to L by 2 strain energy for AC plus 0 to L by 2 strain energy for CB. But here the section will be in the symmetrical manner. That is the reason I am considering 2 times of this section. Otherwise what we have to do? Again we have to consider section from support B, then take down the moment from the left side also. So it is better to take down like this. Then what is the moment up to here? See here, you please remember the section, force into distance. This RVA will be acting like this towards section x, which is acting clockwise. Therefore, you will get RA into x. So, moment in AC span. I am writing here. That one will be equal to RA into x. Again, here UDL will be there. UDL will be there. This UDL will be acting downwards. So, which is acting towards x will be in the anti-clockwise movement here. Therefore, W into x by 2. This will be acting clockwise towards x and this will be acting anti-clockwise towards x. Therefore, minus minus wx by 2, w into x square by 2 means x into x, x square by 2. So take down w x by 2. So here wx square see here, this is wx square. See here, ra into x minus wx square by 2. What is ra value? P plus wl by 2 into x minus wx square by 2. So this is the moment on span AC. Then in place of m square, I am substituting entire this value. P plus w by l by 2 into x minus wx square by 2 into dx. Then simplify by your own step by step. So simplify by your own here. Cancel the possible terms, whatever possible to cancel here. And again here, this is in the form of a minus b whole square. Before that, here 2 and 2 will be common with a square root, so I am taking that one also outside, that is 1 by 4. Then if you see here, you will get this value directly, 1 by 4 EI 0 to L by 2 P plus W into X minus WX square whole square. This is in the form of A minus B whole square. So here simplify, A square minus 2AB plus B square. And again, this is also in the form of the A plus B whole square. Again, you can expand this one, A square plus B square plus 2AB. Like that, you simplify means you will get this equation. And again, you simplify step by step and apply integration for the x terms, means integral of x square will be equal to x cube by 3. And again substitute upper limit minus lower limit, L by 2 and 0. Already we solved up to 5 examples previously. In the same model, you simplify this equation, and after simplifying and applying integration for the x term, and again after substituting the L values, upper limit and lower limit values, directly you obtained this equation, that is this last equation. So after simplifying by your own, you check with this model whether your values will be correct or not. Then after obtaining this equation, what you have to do, take down by using first theorem of the Castiglione. Already we people know the Castiglione theorem for finding the deflection, that is delta will be equal to dou wi by dou p. Here what is wi? Entire this equation. So I am taking entire equation in place of wi. Then I am applying partial differentiation for the only p terms. See here, dou by dou p 1 by 4a will be common. Again p square, dou by dou p for p square will be equal to 2p. And again this l cube by 24 as it is common, which is constant value. And here there will be no p terms, therefore I am taking this, I am neglecting this one, means that is 0. And again here there will be p term, I am partial differentiating with this p term with p. Then you will get for p 2p, for p square you will get p, for p cube you will get 2p, like that 3p square, like that p to the power of n, you will get the variable values. For p square it will be 2p, and for p you will get only one value, that is directly remaining values 2 w l power 4 by 24. Again here same, partial differentiate with respect to p will be equal to 1, that is minus 2 into w l power 4 by 64. So here there will be no p terms, and here also there will be no p terms, so remain like that only. Then check this one, this is your equation after taking partial differentiation. Then like as the previous model, whatever the imaginary load we are introducing, I am taking that one will be equal to 0 in the final stage. So after obtaining your simplification, after getting the equation, what I am doing here, whatever I am introducing the initial stage, in the initial stage whatever the load I am introducing, I am taking that one as equal to 0. Then if you take that p value will be equal to 0, this value will be equal to 0, take down remaining value, 2WL power 4 by 24 minus 2WL power 4 by 64. So if you have calcium units directly substitute in the calculators, you will get this value directly, 5 by WL power 4, 384 EI. Otherwise, take down LCM and again simplify by your own also, you will get this one. So deflection for the simply supported beam, if an UDL is acting, then what is the value here? 5 by 384 WL power 4 by EI. I hope you understand this lecture. If you really like this video, please like this video, share it to your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.